Howdy friends, it's time for another episode of the Blues Heart Biker. Hey everybody, welcome to another episode of the Blues Heart Biker channel. All right, today I'm visiting my buddy Tom over here at the Mystic Music Store. You've seen him a few times on the channel. He's got a BMW. We're gonna take a little afternoon ride just around town, go get some lunch. The interesting thing is that he has never ridden a Harley before. So I think that today, well, you know, today I'm riding the new Night Train that I just got, the new old Night Train that I just got, and it seems to be running pretty good. Today we're gonna let him ride the Night Train and see what he thinks. We're gonna have a BMW Harley Davidson shootout. Now his BMW is from the 90s, so it's a little bit older than mine. My bike is from 07, but his bike was senior citizen owned and my bike was biker owned, and mine's pretty beat up. So it's gonna be a pretty equal match, you know. It's a little older, a little more rough. So we're gonna see. Here he comes right now. There it is. Uh-oh. Yeah, man.
Goodbye, there we go. There it goes.
Cool. That's an R100. Okay, so that's a R100. I thought it was an R80. That's a R100 or a 90. That's a R100. So that's a 1000cc bike. Yeah. There it is, in all of its purple glory. Cool, man. Now it's carbureted, so it's carbureted bike from the 90s, so it's gonna have to warm up. Carbureted bike from the 90s. So it's going to need to warm up a little bit.
Oh, I do too.
Oh.
So another thing, the speedometer's not working right now. I got a cable coming in today. I got to replace the cable.
I'm still kind of shaking this down a little bit.
Yeah.
So in second gear, at about 5,000 or so, is 40 miles an hour.
Okay. Okay. Well, we'll just give her a feel then and see what happens. So, yeah, well, cool, man. Cool. Well, let's do it. What do you think? Are you ready to do it?
I guess so, man. I'm a little nervous.
Yeah. Nervous. Just two wheels. Two wheels and a motor.
Yeah.
Just a big,
right.
Just a big gyroscope. Just keep moving and you'll have no problem. No, you won't have it. The only thing that's going to be a little weird are the apes. But you know, the apes actually make the bike feel lighter.
Wow.
And when you get used to, you know, you just lean a little more and you just, you know, you feel it. Just ride, you know, feel it out. You've never ridden a bike with apes before?
No, I haven't.
Okay. All right, well, this is, it isn't that much difference. It's just, you just gotta control the bike, make it do what you wanna do, and it will. It'll do it, you know, so. All right, well, let's go. One thing on this bike that I've noticed, there's a few little weirdnesses going on with it. The clutch might be slipping a little tiny bit when you are in the lower gears and you accelerate. Also, if you get too much RPM in the first couple of gears, it'll spit and sputter a little, because I think the fuel filter needs to be changed. And then the second gear, when you're downshifting, you kind of got to tap it a little bit. Sometimes it might act like it's in first gear.
Oh, okay.
But sometimes it might not. Usually it doesn't, but sometimes, you know, it'll act like it's in first gear when it's actually in second gear. When you go to downshift it, old Harley stuff. So that's what it is, you know.
What's the pattern?
One down, five up.
All right, five up, wow.
Yeah, six speed. So I doubt you'll get out of fourth. You know, riding around town, you know, it's that six speed is pretty, I think it's overdrive, so it's pretty,
but
you know,
wow,
yeah,
speed.
Yeah,
right, cool.
You get. All right, let's do it.
Hey, dude, watch it. Okay, well, the BMW. It's a very smooth bike. This is an older one. I've never ridden an older one. And I've ridden newer BMWs. Here comes Tom. What do you think, man? It's just still on? Oh, I see. What do you think? You got a rev, you got a rev bomb at the stoplights. That's part of the Harley experience. Oh, I just got a little of the BMW pullover, the boxer pullover. These bikes will tend to kind of pull over to one side when you give them the gas. This one really does it. I noticed the newer BMW, the R1200R that I rode, didn't have that problem. But the R18, man, that thing really pulled to one side. And I can feel it. You can really feel it on this thing. That's hilarious. And so is the Moto Guzzis are like that too. All right, let's see if we can make this go here. This is nice. You know, I can really see why people like BMWs. You know, they are, everything about them is real precision. Yeah. This thing's got a little bit really twist, man. I love it. Okay, we're going over here to get something to eat. We're gonna go to Robert Tito's.
Chicken. Oh, it's gonna be awesome.
Look at this, man.
Look at that. Perfectly made.
Robert Tito's. You can't beat Robert Tito's, can you?
Can't beat it.
Some people say, you know, there's mixed reviews on Robert Tito's, but it's a Fresno based operation, I think. You know, I don't see them anywhere else.
Well, and how can it be bad with a logo like that?
Yeah, like that. Look at Robert Tito. Robert
Authentica.
Tito's a cool little guy. So, all right, well, let's eat and ride. You can see the bike moving around like this while it's idling. I don't know whether you can see that or not, but it's going like this. Yeah. Uh-oh.
carbureted bikes aren't as forgiving. Yeah, there he goes. I think he's getting the hang of it now. Completely two opposite ends of the spectrum. I can feel the exhaust hitting me back here, man. That thing's got some exhaust. Did you sit pretty high on this bike? Feels light, this bike does. A lot lighter than what I'm used to. I like it. Completely different ends of the spectrum. You know, this is a way different machine altogether. He's digging it. He's never ridden a Harley. I bet he's glad he did now. I can feel the exhaust all the way back here from that thing. Every time you hit the exhaust of this thing, it wants to move. I can't get over that. That's funny as heck. Every time I ride one of these, I love that. All right. Thousand cc's this one is, and it's got that, you know, I haven't been able to really push this thing too much because we're riding around town, but I have a feeling it's got that deceiving power like I rode that R1200R, and that thing had the deceivingly crazy amounts of power, and I think that this is the same way, you know. I got a feeling that it does anyway. Yeah, you get right about there, it likes it. The power is deceiving. Like Easy Rider. Bike looks good going down the road. Ha! I think he likes it. Easy rider. Uh-oh, I forgot to put her down in reverse. Look at that Jaguar. Wow. Yes, yes. Interesting. And these turn signals are interesting on this. You turn right and left on it, your kill switch for the turn signals is only on the right side. They almost got it right. Harley has it right. I love the two thumb turn signal. And this does have two thumb turn signal. It's just you can only turn it off on the right thumb. The other side's a horn. Yeah, see, it's got a little get up and go. Like he said, the speedometer doesn't work, so it's hard to see how fast you're going. Bike looks good. Let's wait till I get it all fixed up. Yeah, man. A little backfire there. Got to decide what he wants to do here. Watch out for this dude right here. This guy right here is hiding. I think he parks his right here. Alright. Yeah, man. Yeah, man. Cool.
Alright, man.
Hey,
we're
man.
Back.
Thanks for letting me ride your bike.
Yeah, man. Thank you for letting me ride yours. BMW versus Harley Davidson here today. Completely different animals. Crazy machines, both of them are, you know?
Yeah.
BMW's, the speed and the power that they have is deceiving. You know, it's because everything's so smooth on it. And I noticed that on the bigger, the newer ones that I've ridden, you know. And that's the same way, you know. You give it the gas and it just, it doesn't like throw you. It's just, it just takes you where you want to go, you know. And that bike's no exception. It's interesting. They're interesting pieces of machinery, you know. Two-cylinder bikes like that, they all have a certain character, you know, like V's or boxers, you know. They all have a certain character that inline bikes don't have, you know. It's pretty interesting.
Fun experiment, man.
Yeah.
It's great.
Yeah.
And I had to flip you off just because
I
was doing the easy rider thing. I'm glad you got that. It didn't go well. Damn it. Let's run what,
was
my
the,
motorcycle.
Was the bike that bad?
Yeah, really.
No, I caught it. Of course, Easy Rider's my favorite movie, man.
Oh, of course.
But well, good, man.
Love
so,
it.
Yeah, different, isn't it? It's you've got motorcycle riding and then you got Harleys. You know, I mean, really, that's my whole take on it because. You know, like I was saying earlier, look at how much more metal, how much more frame there is to this motorcycle, you know?
Yeah.
Yes. And you know, this is average for a motorcycle, you know? Most motorcycles are kind of this size, you know? They have about this much frame on them, you know, a Triumph, you know? But then you go over to a Harley and look how long that thing is.
You know? Back tire, yeah. Man.
Yeah, and it's, you know, the thing about Harleys is that they're... They're big and heavy and underpowered, you know, and but it's just something about it. You
know? It felt good, yeah. The power band felt real good. I enjoyed it. Yeah.
Yeah. It's the clutch is slipping a little on it. I know that, you know. Yesterday, I was moving it around in the garage and pulled the clutch in and it wouldn't move in gear. And when I started it this morning, it jumped a little bit when I put it in gear, and then the clutch loosened up. And then,
you know, used bikes, you're doing the shakedown.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm still doing my shakedown.
Bits
are falling off and stuff.
Yeah. Yeah. and of course, the Harley backfire.
Oh, yeah, man. That was cool.
That's from the pipes. The pipes make it run a little lean and causes it to do that. Well, that was fun, man.
That was fun.
Yeah.
Right. I had a backfire a couple weeks ago, and the police came to my door.
Really?
They said, we detected a gun blast. Is everybody here okay? I'm like, no, that was my motorcycle.
Wow. That's crazy.
Harleys must drive me nuts.
Yeah. Next time I'll bring my other Harley over, you can ride that one too.
I'd love to. I want to see the difference.
See the difference between... That one is in pretty good shape, but it's different. It's a different bike, you know.
Is the wheelbase shorter on that one?
The rake is different on it.
Yes.
I think it's pretty much the same frame,
right.
But the rake is not. On this bike, the Night Train has a little bit more rake, and it's lower. This is a little lower than the Softail Deluxe. Softail Deluxe has got the big front end on it, and it's a little... It's actually a little easier to handle in a lot of ways, you know, but it's a different machine altogether. Well, cool, man. Oh, we trade key. Oh, your key's in it.
Yeah.
All right, man. Well.
That was fun. Thanks for coming by.
Yeah, you bet, man. You bet. Did you sell the Royal Enfield?
Not yet. No, it's over there. We're trying to decide what to do with it.
Yeah.
She wants to find something maybe a little smaller.
Yeah.
Try to see. Yeah. What's up?
Well, he's got a Royal Enfield for sale. If anybody in the area is looking for a bike, a great starter bike or a great commuter.
Yeah, it's a good bike.
Little bike for buzzing around, and stylish.
Yep. Yeah,
look
like
back
the
a couple. Look back a couple episodes. I did an episode on it. So, the Royal Enfield has come out with the new Classic 350.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty nice looking motorcycle. And I hear they're coming out with a Classic 650.
Yeah, that one's really interesting. Yeah. It's just sort of more like a cruiser-looking style of thing.
Well, cool, man. Awesome.
All right, John.
Well, that's thanks a lot for riding along today and let you get back to work. Tom's ditching work a little bit today to fool around with motorcycles, so he better get back to it before he has to fire himself.
I'm fired.
All right, like man.
It. All right.
All right, cool.
Bye.
All right, man.
Ha ha.
All right, Tom. Well, it's good to be back on the Harley. I can tell you though, it's a fun bike to ride, the BMW. I could really, really see why people like them. And it's like I was saying, you know, you got, in a lot of ways, you got motorcycles and you've got Harleys. And Harleys are motorcycles, but not all motorcycles are Harleys. See? Oh, see that? See, that's one of the problems it has. And I'm pretty sure that's a fuel filter. Alright, hey, I was going to go to the David Mann Chopper Show this weekend, and I was also going to go to the Classic Motorcycle Museum in Solvang, California. They're about an hour apart from each other down in Southern California by the coast. And it's supposed to rain real bad, and they canceled the David Mann Chopper Show until February. So that's why you're getting Harley versus BMW on this episode and not the Chopper Show and the museum. Come to the conclusion, Harley versus BMW, that it's apples versus oranges. And I understand why people like both. Myself, I'm a Harley guy. And I'm proud of the fact. But I can really, really see why people like BMWs. And if I were to stumble across one and I had money burning a hole in my pocket, and I were to stumble across one that was somebody really needed to get rid of and it was a cheap price, I would consider buying one, maybe, you know, if it came along. As long as I had a couple Harleys in my garage.
Okay, well, I'm back home. I ran out of battery in my GoPro. I think I used one of my old batteries. So anyways, cool thing. One cool thing I didn't show you guys is that Tom gave me this cool jacket. Look at this thing. Yeah. Cool Harley jacket. Got leather sleeves. 50 years of Harley Davidson. And the thing about it is that it's a repro, you know, but it's a Harley Davidson piece of merchandise. But pretty cool. Pretty old school. You know? Harley Davidson, 1903. So that's pretty cool. We're gonna wrap things up today. I'm getting closer to the hip surgery. A week from, I've got 10 days until the hip surgery. So hopefully everything will be all right. I think it will be. I gotta figure out how to get my bike down to the shop to get it started on the paint and the transformation of the night train. But that's all for other episodes. Today's episode is going to come to a close. If you could, I'm going to be real cool right now, be like a real hipster right now. If you could smash that subscribe button, give me that thumbs up, hit that little bell. Now what's going to happen is when you do that, the thumbs up, that's going to let YouTube know that you're kind of digging what's happening here at the Blues Heart Biker channel, and it also makes me feel good about what I'm doing. And another thing is that bell. Now that bell is going to let you know whenever I upload new content. Every Tuesday, every Saturday, 9 a.m. Pacific time on YouTube. Also, leave a comment. Let's hear a comment from you. Again, if anybody's had hip surgery and has motorcycle riding experience after getting their hip replaced, leave me a comment. Let me know how it turned out. So far, nobody's left a comment about that. So, kind of worries me. Nobody's had hip replacement surgery that rides bikes. We'll see what happens. I think it's going to be fine in a few months, but we'll see. All right. Well, anyways, let's wrap it up here, all right? Be sure to tune in again, and we'll see you next time. Stay cool. Be nice to each other, all right? Like, you know, just try to think about somebody else's struggle once in a while before you give them a hard time, or before you pass judgment, or before you, you know, say things, hate things, you know. Just try to think about other people and treat them the way you want them to treat you. Can't miss when you do that, all right? And be cool. Watch out for other bikes, especially when you're driving your car. And be careful when you're riding your bike, okay? Be safe for me. All right, thanks a lot, everybody. We'll see you again next time right here on the Blue Star Biker Channel. All right,